Before we get started, we need to ask permission of my dad if we can begin our program.
My dad, not only a mayor or supervisor of the person, give you permission to begin.
Thank you so much. And she is our elder. So a brief overview of our program today. We will have welcome Sheila Walden and Ms. Evelyn Fox. We will have history given of Springhill and Sugarhill. We will have some door prizes. We will have a Power Coalition presentation. We will have our vendor tables, which some of you have already started to visit. We will have them just come up and give a brief synopsis of their organization so that you know what it is that you need to visit before you leave here tonight. And then we will have dinner after the presentation. And then we will come back and do more drawings and instructions on how to. Windows will be given throughout, so make sure you're paying attention, and I'm going to pass the mic right now.
Hello, everybody. My name is Sheila Baldwin, and I am the chairman of the Sugarhill Community. Y'all hear me? I'm the chairman of the Sugarhill Community, and I would welcome each one of you for taking the time to come out to this adventure. Also, I'd like to thank the Power Coalition for putting this program on. You are welcome to eat with us. You are welcome to play games with us. You are welcome to go to the different vendors. We want you to have fun and enjoy. But it's also informative. We have some tablers outside. They're not vendors because you're not paying for anything. You just get information. Okay? So we have our tables outside, and we want you to win some money and have fun. So again, I say welcome and thanks to the Empower Coalition for putting this on. Thank you.
Very, very educational. Saturday. So there was a lot of things happening before that time. Gainesville was established in 1854, and soon after that, it started getting other communities. So I don't know exactly when Sugarhill came on board, but I know I have a cousin that was born in 1875. His name was Josh Johnson. So they was one of some of the first families of the Johnsons, Nichols, and Danzy. And they were the Baltimore family, Baltimore family. That was their name. And we have two sections on Sugar Hill. Southeast 4th Avenue, run through Sugar Hill. And I'll tell y'all, the reason why I think they call it Sugar Hill, because of the sugar cane and the hills that you see the houses coming on 4th Street. That's where I got that name. I got that name. But I don't know why, because I ask a lot of old people, why are you calling it Sugar Hill? But if you go downtown, you won't see Sugar Hill. You'll see Norwood Heights and Al Washington Estate. But when you come on Sugar Hill, you will see a sign that says Sugar Hill. And also because of all the sweet people that was over there. There were a lot of sweet, lovely people there. When I lived on Sugar Hill, I come from Louisiana. My dad is from Sugar Hill. I was born in Louisiana. He met my mama in Louisiana, and he wanted to come back home with his family. His mom died when he was in the third grade, so he had three homes that stayed on Sugar Hill. And two of them homes are still there. Homes are still there. And he was raised by them. So I have a friend that said, you're not Sugar Hill, you're from Louisiana. I am Sugar Hill because my great-great-great-grandmama was Sugar Hill. And that was in the 1800s. So I am Sugar Hill. All right. When, like you saw, we were Sugar Hill, we had four owners of the property that I knew of. One of the owners were the Payne's family, with Payne's parent is named after. One of the family was named Bridget, Miss Bridget. She owned some of the land where across from that hall Peters used to be. She owned some of that land. Then we had Buddy Cope, he owned land over there. And one more person. Yeah, one more person owned land. But we had four people there, so they bought their land for $10. I found out I was reading on the history, and I found it paid $10 for their land. But if you look at Sugar Hill now, we didn't have paved streets and lights and all that stuff. All we did when we were kids were played outside, pop star, jack stones, and that kind of stuff. Wow. Now the kids, mom and dad, one shot marbles, and they ended up cap guns and stuff like that. But nowadays, these children, they have TVs in their room and TVs by the 7 or 6 girls in my family, and all us stayed in a shotgun house from Sugar Hill, and we never complained. And my grandchildren said, oh, Mom, he touched me. He put his foot on me. You know, the kids have changed. The area has changed now because everybody knew everybody. We had our doors unlocked. Wherever you was, you could eat the neighbors' houses. You didn't worry about your kids down the street because you knew when that street light went off, you better be in that house before that street because you would hear my mom for miles and you didn't want to hear. So you would always run home. And we had the first black person that worked down in a supervisor election was Bobby Higgins. And we named our park was named Bobby Higgins Park. That was the black people working in the community. Beasley Williams was the other person that they knew. Did I say Beasley Williams? That they purchased land from. And now the neighborhoods have changed so much. You don't know who your neighbor is now. Neighbors, we help out each other. We look out for each other. We did so much together. And every year now, we try to have a Sugar Hill reunion. Every now and then, we don't come together because of COVID. And then last year, nobody want to take it over. I had hit by a spider, and nobody want to take it over. And I wasn't able to do it. So we didn't do it last year. Every year, we have people coming from Texas, Atlanta, that grew up on Sugar Hill, or their parents. And this year we'll be having it, and quite a few people from Sugar Hill is here today, and I just want to understand, you know, we have a great history over there.
Did everybody catch that? A blue Chevy Equinox, license plate CV4984. Also, if you need to use the restrooms, they are through these doors right there. Okay, next we're going to have Mr. Otis Silver come up and give a history of Springhill Neighborhood.
Good evening. I heard that Bob's history of Springhill. Well, Springhill is when it could just interchange the name. It was a marvelous neighborhood to grow up in. I grew up here on Springhill. Matter of fact, Monica is my niece. Our family is personally old property, old Springhill since 1904, most of which we still own to this day. Springhill was the kind of community where everybody knew everybody. The street I grew up on, 9th Street, we had neighbors across the street, Ms. Rosetta and Mr. Jim, they always was on the porch. No matter what time of the morning you got up, they already out there. And no matter what time of the evening you came out, they were out there. If something went on 9th Street, they knew it and they was gonna tell it. I remember the first time I heard the term latchkey kids, I laughed. I'm like, well, we always came home and after 2 hours, you know, mom and dad had to work. So we came home and we came in the house. Something happened, Ms. Rosetta was coming across the street. And she was gonna ask me what she was doing. And before mom and dad could get in the driveway, they was already coming back to tell. So, you know, you didn't do anything. So somebody was always watching. That was the kind of neighborhood that this was. It was vibrant, loving, and caring. One of the things that I noticed over the years about African American neighborhoods, you can usually date them by churches that are in the neighborhood. Our church, my Alachua church over here, was founded in 1883. Well, that's about the time Springhill, probably Springhill too, came in. We had all of these African American neighborhoods in Gainesville came about after the Civil War. And if you didn't know, back in 1850, when Gainesville was getting incorporated, there were more enslaved people in Alachua County than there were white people. So we outnumbered them, and after the war, we pretty much stayed. And we started buying property, Jonesville, Sandhill, Roughnecks, Dave, Arizona, you know, Sugar Hill, Spring Hill, Poland, you know, on and on. These are all private communities of African American people, all doing well, all looking out for each other and helping each other to live. The other term that they're putting out now that we need to talk about was the shotgun house, what they call the tanning house. When I first heard that, I just laughed. You know, it was 6 of us, and yeah, we was in a house about half the size of the stage, and we all got along just fine. And I tell people when I grew up, nobody in my neighborhood was like 6.